Shadow here for another Let's Play of Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Here with me is Nightshade.
I don't remember anything.
I don't remember anything either. We kind of took a little bit of a break, recording-wise, so this may not be as noticeable, maybe. But we kind of took a little bit of a break because I had to do a lot of moving. So now we're back.
SDQ happened.
Yeah, I know. A lot of things happened. So SGDQ happened, lots of events, stuff like that. So here we are. We're going to continue. That sounds loud.
Whoa. You picked the wrong episode here.
Did I pick the wrong episode? Is it continue?
You have to do continue.
Oops. I'm so sorry. I didn't realize it was on the wrong one. Continue. There we go. Turnabout Goodbyes, Day 3 Trial. Oh.
Here we go.
No. Here we go.
December 27th, 10 a.m., District Court, Courtroom Number 3.
Number 3.
This is the second day of court.
Holy moly, this is loud. Sorry about that mishap. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Miles Edgeworth. The defense is ready, Your Honor. Ooh, it's so good to be Phoenix again. Oh. He's, like, gripping on, like...
Very well. Apparently, the prosecution is also ready. Apparently, the prosecution is pissed.
Who is the judge here, anyway?
Mr. Von Karma, your opening statement. Very well. No opening statement, so...
Objection! Not so fast, Judge. I was taking a meaningful pause before speaking.
Right, of course.
A prediction. Today's trial will end 3 minutes from now.
Really?
Yes. You got a problem with that?
Order! Mr. Von Karma, what is the meaning of your statement just now?
Bah! Must you question everything?
Yes.
It will be over in 3 minutes. We have no time to waste. Cue the chopper! I'll call my witness now.
Right.
I call my witness. My decisive witness to the stand.
It's that mysterious boat shop owner. Oh, it's Mr. Kooky Man! Yeah! Old Mr. Kooks!
Witness, state your profession.
He's sleeping.
I'm the proprietor of the restaurant The Wet Noodle on Court Lake. I also rent boats.
The night of the incident, you were in the boat rental shop, correct?
Yep, I was.
Please testify.
Wait a second. We still haven't heard who this old guy is. Objection! Wait a minute. The witness hasn't stated his name yet.
Because I did not ask him, Mr. Wright! Bah! I have predicted this trial will end in 3 minutes. Stop asking trivial questions and cooperate.
That's illegal! He has to state his name. That is such bull. Yeah, right.
You do not question Von Karma.
The witness will state his name.
I'm not really sure. Yep.
What do you mean?
My, memory. Also the gin I took before coming in.
Your Honor, the witness does not remember anything beyond the last several years. A very severe case of drunkenness. Ergo, he cannot recall his own name.
So then, shouldn't he have been given a different name then? This does not make any sense whatsoever.
We'll call him Skippy the Duck.
Like...
How about it?
He can't recall, you say?
Yes, but the incident in question took place 3 days ago. He can't testify.
Testify,
Skippy!
Very well. Let's hear his testimony then, shall we, witness?
Witness testimony, the night of the murder.
You think I talked a lot today.
I'll change soon. It was the night of the 24th, just after midnight. Yep. I was in the restaurant,
red boats, as usual. Spaghetti boats. Then I heard a bang. Yep. And then Smiley just showed up on my window. When I looked out the window, I saw a smiley face that was looking like a boat, just floating on the lake. Then I heard another bang.
Okay.
Just about then, the boat comes back to shore, and a man walks by my window.
Very well. I like to begin the cross-examination. What?
There is nothing to question in my witness testimony.
Bullcrap.
Ergo, no need for cross-examination.
Bullcrap.
Besides, there are only 10 seconds left before our 3 minutes are up. Judge, your verdict, now!
Yes, Mr. Wright. Don't cross-examine. Come on. What are you saying? Of course I'll cross-examine the witness.
Very well. You may begin.
Oh my god. Excuse me, Mr. Von Karma?
3 minutes just passed.
I see. Well then, let's just take our time. Need some salt for that wound?
That probably peaked on the recording, by the way.
You may cross-examine the witness.
Alrighty, we're gonna skip the script. Oh my god. Alright. Blah, 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 blah. Just after midnight, you say?
Yep. Just around then.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure, yep.
When I talked to you yesterday, you were rather vague about the time. I'm surprised you seem so sure about it today. Oh my god.
I asked him, and he remembered. Isn't that right?
Bubble pop.
Don't glare at me like that, giant cranberry man. I remember it clearly. I did. Yup.
You see? Continue.
Hold it. Is there anyone who can verify that?
Well, I guess Polly could.
That's not good enough for a court of law.
Oh, yeah, really?
Mr. Wright, exactly what's not good enough?
Your Honor, this Polly is a parrot.
A parrot?
Don't be so hard on the girl, Katie Boy.
Oh, that's right, I forgot. We had names.
Yogi Boy. The prosecution concedes that we cannot prove the witness was in the shop. Witness, please continue.
And I heard a bang. Yep, I forgot that was already said.
And where did the bang seem to come from?
From the lake, I figure.
Are you certain?
Yep.
Good. Continue. Now keep going, because those 3 minutes has elapsed and my lasagna's waiting.
Was there someone in the boat?
I was pretty far out there. I couldn't see clearly.
But I figure there was two men out there. Yep.
But you couldn't see them clearly.
Yep. At the time, that is.
At the time? So you heard two gunshots total?
Yep.
That's what Lotta said in her testimony yesterday. It's the last one. By your window?
Yep, by my window. Right outside the window of my little shack.
And could you see the man's face?
I was about to say snack.
The snack.
Well, the fog was pretty darn thick, but he was right there in front of me. I saw him.
This is rather important detail. Please add it to your testimony.
Sis.
I have a bad feeling about this. Okay, so...
That man was the defendant. He was saying, I can't believe he's dead.
Are you sure? Uh-oh. Dad!
That's certain, Keith! He said, I can't believe he's dead as he was walking by too.
That was slightly going into Manila for some reason.
Witness, are you sure that the person you saw was Miles Edgeworth?
It was him! That Edgeworth boy!
Oh god, he fell.
I can remember that pretty face everywhere!
This sounds like decisive evidence indeed. I see no room for doubt.
Von Karma. He lured me into cross-examining so he could set me up for a fall.
The 3 minutes was a joke. Just.
Nick! I don't like the way fiends are going here. Everyone in the courtroom is glaring at us.
I better act quick. Well, this trial is going to be over. Wait and see what happens. No. Your Honor, we proved in yesterday's court that it could not have been Edgeworth who fired that gun.
Mr. Wright, are you referring to the fingerprints from Edgeworth's right hand found in the gun? And the photograph showing a man firing with his left hand?
Exactly!
That is easily explainable. He could have wiped his prints after he fired. You are ignoring the truth of the matter here. Everything in this witness testimony is true.
The judge is lost in thought. What should I do?
Objection!
Really? Like, this is where I kind of question the game's logic. Like, really? Someone's gonna say, let's just wait and see what happens. Burp. Your Honor. This witness claims that Edgeworth said, I can't believe he's dead. But his word is all we have. If he were telling a lie...
Mr. Wright, in a court of law, the evidence tells all.
Bullcrap.
Apparently you have yet to realize even this basic fact, amateur. If you say his testimony is a lie, show us proof.
Nick! Do we have evidence?
It's no good. There's nothing I can do.
Are you sure?
To be honest, I don't know what to do anymore.
Please! Can you hear me, sis? Please! We need your help! Nick needs you!
Tss. 3 minutes was perhaps too high in expectation. However, 15 minutes isn't bad. This must be a new record.
It's kind of legitimately been 15 minutes. That's kind of the creepy part about that.
New record!
Enough. The witness may leave the stand.
This court sees no reason to further prolong the trial. Nor is there any need for more time to decide the case against the defendant. This case is extremely clear. I see no room for misinterpretation for the facts.
What? No!
This court finds the defendant, Mr. Miles Edgeworth. Guilty.
It's lasagna time.
The accused will surrender to the court immediately, to be held pending trial at higher court within a month from today's date. That is all. The court is adjourned. Really?
Whoa, wait!
Who was that just now?
Me!
Huh?
Ah! Larry! Oh my god, I forgot about Larry! I totally forgot about Larry!
Who the hell is this loser?
When something smells, it's usually the butts.
Well, what are you doing here?
Listen, you gotta listen to me! I was there in the park the night of the murder! I wasn't sure about it until yesterday. But today I remembered it.
Remembered what?
The gunshot! I heard it too! Oh my god. What?
Order, order!
What is the meaning of this? The verdict has been decided. I call for adjournment. And lasagna.
One moment, Mr. Von Karma. So you say you heard a gunshot?
Yeah, I did! A gunshot! That night! I was sitting here in the audience, listening to the testimony. Then I realized something he said was different from what I remembered. Anyhow, I can't just sit here and let you call Edgy a murderer. It's just not right! I'll testify! Let me testify!
What the heck is that loser?
Larry.
What a order! Well, this is the first time something has happened like this in my court.
Really?
I'm not quite sure how to proceed.
Judge, you've already given your decision! The trial is over!
Nick! This is it! Larry's giving us one final chance at this!
She's right! If only it wasn't Larry.
Wasn't Larry.
I think we found the episode's name.
Right? Oh. He could make things even worse.
Mr. Edgeworth was just declared guilty, Nick. It doesn't get any worse.
You're right. Okay. Your Honor, there's another witness. It is our duty to hear him speak. Right here, right now.
A waste of time. Verdict cannot be overturned.
Allow me to speak my opinion.
You have an opinion?
In all court proceedings, it is our duty to prevent an inaccurate verdict.
Oh, God.
In order to make sure no mistake has been made, every witness should be heard.
How did that work out for you in the past? What is this?
I withdraw my previous verdict of guilty. Let's add a little more salt to that wound. Mr. Von Karma, I order you to call this new witness to testify. Now.
What?
The court will adjourn for a 5-minute recess. After that, we will hear this new witness. Court is adjourned.
Larry, save the day.
How can I make this witness disappear in 5 minutes?
December 27, 10:28 a.m., District Court Defendant Lobby Number 2.
Hold on a sec. I'm gonna move this just a little bit. There you go.
I'm going to take a sip.
Whew! That was too close. Sorry to keep you on the edge of your seat like that, Edgeworth.
God.
Get
it?
Edgeworth? Oh.
No. That one came from the game. You don't get any credit from it.
I've seen worse. Yeah, right, Edgeworth. You're sweating bullets. I just wonder what Larry plans to say in there.
Larry was at the lake that night?
Yes. He said he went looking for the steel samurai balloon that flew into the lake.
Oh, right.
That did
happen.
And he
found the balloon in the air tank that night?
Yeah. Hey, Edgeworth. Huh. You say something, right?
Yeah, a lot of things. You seem out of it. What's wrong?
It's nothing.
Mr. Edgeworth, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
What's that?
Why are your fingerprints on the murder weapon?
Oh.
Well, that one lost an eye.
When he fell into the lake, I went into a daze. I couldn't understand what had happened. I couldn't think straight. Then I saw the pistol lying on the floor of the boat in front of me. I picked it up without thinking. I didn't have a reason, really.
That's going to be like
I
that.
I see.
Right. Yeah? This might be our chance.
Our chance?
Von Karma has only ever run perfect trials.
Perfect trials?
Perfectly prepared witnesses, perfectly complete evidence. That's the secret to his success. This is the first time he's ever had to deal with something unexpected. He has let someone he hasn't even talked to testify before to court. And that someone is Larry.
What are you getting at?
It's likely his testimony will be full of holes, right?
That's right, Nick! No 10-minute trial this time! We'll milk this one for all it's worth!
Hey, it was 15 minutes! 15! Everything depends on Larry now.
We're screwed. December 27, 10:35 a.m., District Court, Courtroom Number 3? Wait, it's a defendant lobby through, but Courtroom 3? I thought they were connected.
I don't know.
Moving along!
Court is now back in session. Witness, please testify to the court about everything that you saw. On the night of December 24th,
right! Leave it to me! Please, Larry, don't mess this one up.
He's totally going to mess this one up.
I hate to admit it, but you're our last chance. Karma didn't even have time to prep his witness.
I didn't have time to kill him. I mean...
I didn't have time to strangle him. I just hope Edgeworth is right about this being our big break.
Witness testimony the night of the murder.
That night, I was out in a boat on the lake. I was looking for something and I found it. So I quietly slipped the boat back in at the rental shop dock. Then, just as I was thinking about going home, I heard this bang! Looked out over the lake, but I didn't notice the boat. So after I heard that single gunshot, I went home.
That was an unusually vague testimony, even for this court. In any matter, Mr. Wright, you may begin your cross-examination.
I'm fairly sure we've seen worse.
I'm fairly sure, too. Yes, Your Honor.
What's wrong, Nick?
It's Larry. I have no idea what he's going to say if I press him. I'm a little scared.
Well, we've come this far. There's no way to go but forward, Nick!
Cross-examination. The night
here
of the
murder. Here we go. Bloody blah 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 blah.
Something wrong, Mr. Wright?
There were so many things wrong, I don't know where to begin.
Ah.
well, okay. First of all, what time was it? Oh, it was after 11 when I went out in a boat.
Okay.
By that time, everyone had gone home for the night. So I waited until the coast was clear, so to speak. And why were you out on a boat at such a late hour?
Illegally.
looking for something?
Yeah. Mr. Buds, what was it you were looking for?
What the witness was searching for is irrelevant. And personally, I don't want to hear it. Most likely, he was hunting for this Gordy.
You know, it wouldn't surprise me one bit if that was the truth.
This is all irrelevant. Let's get it over with. I have lasagna waiting.
The lasagna is going to be overcooked now. Around what time was that?
Well, let's see. I figured it was out searching for about an hour. I guess it was around 12. Yeah.
You're not sure?
Hey, don't give me that face! I'm not some sort of human sundial, okay?
People use watches these days, Larry.
These days, we don't use watches anymore.
I know, right? Isn't that sad? Where did the sound come from?
Yeah, well, I wasn't too sure about that. I looked around, you know.
Did you look at the lake?
Yes, I looked.
Okay. Wasn't there a boat on the lake?
Order, order. Well, Mr. Butts?
Whoa, whoa. Everybody, just calm down, okay? I mean, it was real foggy that night. I'm not sure whether there was a boat out there or not.
Oh, okay, no problem. That's just the most important part of the case. Oh, Larry. So, you only heard one bang, correct?
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, Nick?
It was a pretty wishy-washy testimony, wasn't it? I guess I should just start working on the contradictions.
Sorry. I wish I could be more helpful. I wish I could call my sister.
It would be the last one, right?
Yep.
Okay, I won't say, oh my god, it takes forever to get to the end.
Come on, King. Let me get to the end.
And then, what are we gonna present? Is it the testimony?
Yeah, we don't have a testimony. You could probably take a look at your evidence. It's been weeks.
But, like, what's gonna prove it?
Well, there is one piece of evidence that will tell you the number two.
The pistol?
Oh, wait.
Huh. Says it was fired 3 times.
Yeah, now that makes me... sorry, that makes me wonder if this is actually too early for the pistol.
It might be.
Because we are going to
it's
establish...
It's going to have to be Lotta's then, right?
Yeah, there we go. I didn't know we had that.
Just after midnight. But he said it was... It could have been before that. He said it was about around...
We're 12. Getting ahead here. First of all, we just have to contradict that he shot.
This is it then, right? I sure hope it is.
It's supposed to contradict this, right. And it's going to contradict something else anyway, so...
Alright. Wait a sec, Larry!
What?
You only heard one bang? You sure?
That's what I said!
But Miss Lotta Hart testified yesterday that she heard 2 bangs! And the old man just now said the same thing! They both heard 2 gunshots that night! Were you even listening? Were you paying attention at all to what they said?
Yo, Nick, please!
Huh?
You know, something's been bothering me. I'm a witness, see? I'm like a customer here.
No!
So you gotta treat me nice and stuff, okay?
Mr. Butch.
What?
You only heard 1 gunshot, are you sure?
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm not sure. Not sure? How could you not be so sure?
Yeah, well, I might have missed the other gunshot. I was listening to something else.
Something else?
I'm gonna strangle that kid.
My radio, dude, on my headphones.
Oh my god, I could be eating lasagna right now.
Order, order, and stop that boom. Mr. Butts,
you
were listening
Butts.
To a radio on earphones? Yeah, so what? That a crime? I listen to my radio. Everybody listens to radio. What's the big deal? Mr. Von Karma, your opinion?
Waste of time, and I wished I killed him already. I do not accept this witness, nor his Shodi testimony. I am hungry. I want to get out of here.
Well, Mr. Wright, should you continue the testimony? We are continuing, baby. Your Honor, please, please allow the witness to continue his testimony.
Bah! Nothing is more pitiful than a liar who doesn't know when he's lost. In the
Very
dark,
well, Mr. Butt.
All alone.
Please give your testimony and be sure to include details like your radio. Right, leave it to me.
I wouldn't if there were any other way out of this. Believe me.
I wonder if I can get some carry out.
What Larry heard. It's lonely being alone on Christmas Eve. That's why I was listening to an all-request show on the radio, see? I was listening to it real booming loud, like, but I'm sure I heard that gunshot. I remember exactly what the DJ was saying when I heard it, too.
You were listening to your radio at a high volume?
Yeah, what's the big problem? Can't a man listen to his radio in peace? Isn't this a free country?
America.
I truly believe Larry has no idea what the problem here is.
Judge? Can you believe a word that witness says? What he heard was probably nothing more than a drumbeat from the radio.
True enough. It is difficult to believe this testimony.
Wait, Your Honor. The witness said he remembers exactly what the DJ said when he heard the gunshot.
Excuse me? DJ?
DJ!
An announcer, the guy who says things on the radio. Anyway, what this means is when he heard the sound, no music was playing. The DJ only talks between songs, so he could have heard the gunshot from the lake. I'd like to cross-examine the witness, Your Honor.
Very well, Mr. Wright.
I can't believe I'm continuing this charade.
I can't believe he's continuing this charade.
I can't believe it's not butter.
Hold it!
Alright. So, you turn on the radio.
Right! I just wanted to hear someone's voice, you know? Don't know what it's like out there alone on Christmas Eve. Alone!
I shouldn't have said anything. Do you by any chance remember the name of the program you were listening to?
This has nothing to do with your case, Your Honor.
Objection sustained. The witness was listening to the radio. That is all we need to know. Tell us, Mr. Butts, how loud was your radio set to that night?
Hold it.
Real booming loud?
Yeah, you know. And you had headphones on?
Yep.
I wouldn't think you could hear anything going on outside at all.
I should have strangled him when I had the chance.
Said earphones, not headphones. Can you prove that? No. No, of course you can't.
Nah, I can't prove it. But I remember that moment real clear. I mean, while I was talking about it, it came back real clear to me, you know?
I mean, headphones are technically also a valid term, depending on what kind of earphones it is.
What did he say?
Mr. Wright, please cease these pointless questions. What possible good could knowing what a radio DJ said to us?
Indeed, Mr. Von Karma has a point. I'll allow the question only if you see some reason why we should care. We should care.
We should?
We should care, Your Honor. Of course we should.
Why? Because of the Care Bears?
Well, how do you know if we don't ask, hmm? Fine. Very well.
What?
Mr. Butts, please testify to the court. What was the radio announcer saying when you heard the gunshot?
That was
just
way
when
too
she
easy.
Said,
Hey, it's almost Christmas. I heard the gunshot. And bam! Are you sure? Of course I am. She had this real sexy voice. Maybe Von Karma was right. I'm not sure how that helped us at all. This is the most ludicrous testimony I've ever heard. But there is one gleaming ray of hope in there. We've got to press it until we get to the bottom of what happened. Oh, do I gotta do this again? Oh, fudge.
Yeah, that's what happened when you pressed
it. We know what it was, and it was the time, because we're so good at the game.
Speaking of that, we're past time. Do you want to keep going, or?
We'll go through this little part, and then we'll...
Okay.
So what is it that says it?
Same thing as earlier. Wait.
Oh, it's gonna be the... This.
Nope.
No.
Oh, wait.
Because it says 1150.
Nope. Yeah, but that... We want to contradict something. There we go.
Her. Okay. All right. Yeah, that's right. Objection! Okie doke. Larry, are you absolutely sure what you're saying is correct? Huh? What's with the face? You look scary, dude. Hey, if you're trying to scare me, you better know I don't scare that easy.
Is something the matter, Mr. Wright?
Your Honor, did you hear what the witness just said? The DJ said, hey, it's almost Christmas, when he heard the gunshot.
Indeed, and?
Almost Christmas means it wasn't Christmas. Do you realize what this means? When he heard the gunshot, it was still Christmas Eve!
That would seem to be the case, yes.
But that contradicts the two testimonies we have heard so far, Your Honor. Both Miss Hart and the old man said it was after midnight when they heard the shots. In other words, when they heard the gunshots, it was already Christmas. This is a clear contradiction, Your Honor.
What? What does this mean? The two prior witnesses heard gunshots after midnight. However, this witness says he heard a gunshot before midnight.
Judge, the answer is simple. The current witness is plainly mistaken and is a giant idiot. Just look at him. Suspicious.
What?
Well, Mr. Wright, what do you think about Mr. Butts' claim he heard the gunshot before midnight?
Larry's right.
For once. Larry's not mistaken, Your Honor. He heard the gunshot before midnight.
Intriguing. I'm assuming you have evidence for this wild claim. Show me evidence there was a gunshot before midnight, and there we go.
Actually, no, that actually makes sense.
What? The camera?
No, the one you were talking before.
Oh, one sec, where is it? This one, the second photo. Yeah. Take that! Look at this photograph. This was taken by our witness yesterday, Miss Lotta Hart, with her automatic camera. The timestamp on the photo reads December 24th, 11:50 p.m.
Oh yeah? But there's nothing on the lake in this picture.
Your Honor, the real issue here is not why nothing is shown in this photograph. It is why this photograph exists at all.
What do you mean?
Your Honor, you're a dumb...
I mean, it's been a few weeks, Phoenix.
God.
He has to be reminded.
This photograph was taken by an automatic camera. That camera was set to go off in response to loud noises.
Aha! Uh-huh.
Correct! There was a loud noise on the lake at 11:50 p.m. That is why this photograph was taken. In other words, when Larry heard that gunshot, it was most definitely Christmas Eve.
Indeed, it would seem that this is the case. Then where does that leave us? Miss Hart testifies that she heard the gunshots after midnight. Are you claiming she was mistaken?
Not at all, Your Honor. It is a fact that the camera also triggered at 15 minutes after midnight. Your Honor, that night there were two sets of gunshots with a 25-minute pause between them.
Why would this be?
Don't be fooled, George. That camera was set to respond to Lloyd. Loud noises.
I tried to get my gold points together.
There is no proof that the loud noise at 11:50 was a gunshot. Why? The witness could have sneezed, triggering the camera.
Hey, my nose is clear that night. Man, clear.
Well, Mr. Wright, there's no turning back now. Can you prove that the loud noise at 11:50 was indeed a gunshot?
The
Please show us the
bar.
Court evidence if you have any.
The what penalty is... bar is here.
I know.
We're going full circle with this one.
Hold on, I'm looking. Wait, would it be the picture? This picture?
No. Take number 3.
Wait, it would be the pistol then now?
I believe so. We have to prove that there were 3 shots that night. And this
which would be the pistol,
times.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah, because I mean, that makes sense. Let's hope this is.
Also,
this is my evidence.
Also, the pistol is pointing at Phoenix. Nope, not the judge's head.
Something about this pistol was bothering me, Your Honor. Both of the witnesses who testified yesterday heard 2 gunshots. However, the murder weapon was fired 3 times. When, then, was the last shot fired? Only now have I realized the truth. That 3rd shot was the shot Larry heard just before midnight.
Order. That would make sense of the evidence we've seen so far. However, this leaves me wondering exactly what did happen that night on the lake.
Exactly. If this is true, there were 2 sets of gunshots, separated by 25 minutes. One at 11:50, another at 15 minutes after midnight. Why, I ask you, why?
Uh-oh. I better think of something quick. Wait a second. Gunshots separated by 25 minutes?
Ah! What's wrong, Nick?
I have it!
Huh?
Remember the case with the Steel Samurai?
Huh? Yeah, of course I remember.
The murderer in this case had the same idea as the murderer in that case.
What do you mean?
Maya!
Yes?
If we don't figure this out now, we'll never overturn Edward's guilty verdict. I've got a hunch, and I'm going to run with it.
Right. I mean, is this safe?
Safe? We've already gotten a guilty verdict. We have nothing to lose. You just watch and let me know if I say anything that sounds fishy, okay?
Right, Nick.
Your Honor?
Yes, Mr. Wright.
The testimony just now has cleared up this entire case.
What is he going to do?
What do you mean, Mr. Wright?
So, you finally realize the truth. There can be no the murderer that here.
Aw, damn it. Let me retry that because screen refresh and completely got the stakes away.
Go ahead.
Let's try it.
There can be no other murderer here than Miles Edgeworth himself.
Wrong, Von Karma. A man was shot that night, but it wasn't Edgeworth who did the shooting.
Listen, rookie. Take a deep breath and consider the facts. At the time of the murder, one boat was on that lake. This was shown by my witness's photograph. The defendant, Edgeworth, and the victim, Robert Hammond, were on that boat. There was a gunshot fired on that boat, and Robert Hammond fell into the lake. The distance of the shooting was 1 meter. It couldn't have been suicide. Well, the guilty party has to be the other man on that boat.
I imagine it's hard to imagine any other possibility.
Yes, but this assumes that the victim was shot at 15 minutes after midnight.
What do you mean by that, Mr. Wright?
We have photographic evidence of the time of the shooting. It
timestamp on the photo says 0015.
But Larry heard a gunshot 25 minutes before that. Robert Hammond was killed then, 25 minutes before the shot on the lake. It's the only way that Edward could be innocent.
Mr. Wright, are you quite mad? Explain who this is sitting on the boat.
Yeah, Edward's in the murder. Of course, it was Edward N. the murderer. After the murderer killed Robert Hammond at 11:50, he assumed the guise of Mr. Hammond and met Edward.
What? Are you serious?
Yes, Edward won't tell us why he went to the lake that night. However, I have a hunch. That night, Robert Hammond called Edward to the lake. Now, Edward didn't know Robert Hammond's face that well. That's why he didn't suspect anything when the murderer took Robert Hammond's place.
I'm not sure what to make of all this.
Ludicrous.
Mr. Wright, tell us the name of the murderer then.
The murderer's name? Right. It's...
I don't know.
Actually, I don't know the murderer's name.
You don't know?
Bah! Again you waste my time!
I don't know because he never told us. The murderer is the caretaker of the boat shop. That old man. At 11:50, he was the one who killed Robert Hammond.
The caretaker of the boat shop? Where did he do this? There weren't any boats on the lake then.
Why would he have to go all the way out on the lake just to shoot someone? May I suggest that the real scene of this crime was not in a boat?
What? Well then, where did the murder take place?
Show the judge where the murder really took place.
Yes.
It would be a shack, right?
Yes. The shooting shack.
The snack shack.
The snack
Here,
shack.
Of course. The boat shop, where he lives. That way he could meet with the victim without anyone seeing.
Do you have proof that the boat shop was the scene of the crime?
Recall Larry's testimony, if you will.
Yeah, that sounds about
look
Larry's
at that boat going.
That sounds about Larry's
That night
movement.
He was out on the lake in the boat, searching for something.
I am lost!
He finds it and returns the boat. Then, just as he's starting to head for home, he hears a gunshot. You heard a gunshot, Your Honor. Even though he was wearing headphones at the time. In other words, the gunshot was very, very close by. And where would that be if he had just returned the boat?
The boat shop.
The boat shop.
Good job, Judge. You're so smart.
Mr. Wright, what happened that night on Gord Lake? Please tell the court from the beginning.
Yes, Your Honor. Nick, are you sure about this? Not really. But I think if I start at the very beginning, and I take it slow, I might just be able to figure this out. Boy, that sounds like such an innuendo. That night, the caretaker of the boat shop called Robert Hammond to his shop.
Wow, that face.
Yep. This was around 11:50. That was when the gunshot that Larry heard was fired. After that, the caretaker put on Robert Hammond's coat. He became Robert Hammond.
That's not how it works.
Then he got in the boat with Edward and went out into the middle of the lake.
Then who fired the pistol on the boat, Mr. Wright?
Of course, it was the murderer who shot the pistol. He shot twice. Both missed Edward on purpose.
Wait a minute.
Yes?
Why would he shoot twice if he didn't mean to hit anyone?
Details.
Know this, Mr. Wright. The moment you run out of explanation is the moment you lose. Tell us why the murderer had to fire twice.
To create a witness, right? I believe he saw it twice to create a witness, Your Honor.
Create a witness?
The murderer lifts his pistol and fires one shot. That ensures that anyone who heard that shot would look at the lake. Indeed, Miss Hart did exactly that after hearing the first gunshot. Next, the murderer waits a bit and he fires again. Then... the murderer jumps from the boat himself, leaving the pistol in the boat behind him.
I see. To someone looking from the edge of the lake, it would appear that one of the men on the boat had shot the other.
The murderer didn't know about the automatic camera, of course. That's why he shot twice to draw attention to the boat. Once you realize that, everything falls into place. The boat shop caretaker swam back to his shop. Then he put Mr. Hammond's wet coat back on the body and threw the body into the lake. This is what happened, Your Honor. These are the events that transpired that night on Gourd Lake. I'm Phoenix Wright, Channel 11. Back to you.
What the hell did I just listen
Bailiff?
To?
Bailiff? Bring out the witness from before. The boat shop caretaker. Quickly.
On it, sir.
Oh, boy. We need to take a break.
We can't.
Oh, boy.
We can't anymore.
Very well. Well, while we are waiting for the caretaker, I would like to ask the defendant, Miles Edgewood, a few questions. Mr. Edgewood, please take to the stand. Mr. Edgewood, you heard what the defense has said.
Yes.
Well, why did you go to the lake that night?
What Wright has said was mostly correct. Astonishingly so, actually. Yes. Several days ago, I received a letter. The letter was signed Robert Hammond. He asked me to come to the boat shop by the lake at midnight on Christmas Eve. He said he had something very important to discuss with me.
Something important?
I'm sorry. I can't say what it was.
Your Honor, sir!
Bailey, we are conducting a trial here. I asked you that... I asked that you remain quiet.
The witness has disappeared! He isn't in the boat shop either!
What?
What shall I do?
Find him, quickly! We cannot allow him to get away. Mr. Von Karma, your witness has disappeared.
A search warrant has already been issued.
It goes without saying that I cannot declare a verdict under these circumstances. I will extend the trial until tomorrow, the final day allowed. At request of the police department, utilize all its forces to find that witness. Am I understood? One more thing. Just who is that boat shop caretaker? I think his identity has become very important to this trial. I want him, and I want to know who he is. Which is stupid, because they should have already known who he was. Ugh. Anyways, very well. Court is adjourned. Holy poop.
I wonder if I can order pizza.
Okay. We can either stop here, or just spend another minute until the to be continued.
Let's spend another minute. Go.
December 27, 1:22 p.m., District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2, speedrun time.
Yay, Nick! You did it!
Yeah. Well, at least we got out from under that guilty verdict.
And what about Larry? That was something else! Even Von Karma didn't know what to do with his testimony. Larry really helped us out!
Sure, once I sifted through his unique testimony. Still, he did save us. I just wish our cases weren't so down to the wire all the time.
I know what you mean. Sometimes I feel like it's us on trial instead of our clients.
Hey, Edgeworth.
Mr. Edgeworth?
Did you say something?
Don't look so pained. I mean, it looks like you're probably going to get off the hook. You could try to smile just a little. Relax.
I'm sorry. but I fear it's not over for me yet. What do you mean? Right. There's something that's been troubling me for a long time now, and I don't know whether or not to tell you. Edgeworth? No, there's so little time left. I want to tell you to get it off my chest, but... I can't make up my mind.
Now I know what you're thinking, and it's not that.
What is this about, Edgeworth? It's a nightmare I've had. A memory of a crime that I committed. A crime you committed? A memory of a murder.
And there we go.
To be continued! That was so long. We did it.
We did
so, in the next episode, holy poop, that was a long one.
Yeah, you always seem to be in that kind of trance when in court.
I can't help it, dude. There's so much going on.
I know.
I can't help it. All right. In the next episode, we will continue onward and hopefully find out who the kooky old man is. And as well as
him himself, because he's missing.
Yep, and also find out what Edgeworth is talking about. So this was Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, with me and Nightshade.
I wanted to finish with Von Karma voice, but no, it's been long enough.
And with that, we are out of here.